Hello everyone to a new YouTube video by me, The Art of Building. I know that in my past videos I mostly talked about more advanced building tactics, so I think it's only appropriate to do something for the beginners. Because many new players don't know how bunkers work, and in my opinion bunkers are still one of the best ways to protect your loot, I wanted to dedicate an entire video to the different types of bunkers. Let's begin with the classic stability bunkers. You're going to place a square foundation, two half walls on top of each other, where your bunker entrance should be, a wall on the side, destroy the lower foundation, place a triangle foundation next to the square in the direction of your entrance, and two raised triangle foundations on its side. Now this bunker already can be used. To seal this bunker, you would place a twig half wall here and a floor triangle here. The floor triangle would be upgraded to metal, and now your bunker would be sealed. To open up the bunker for you to leave or to enter, you would spawn inside of your bag, which would be placed in here. Then you would use a tool to headshot out this half wall. And because this floor doesn't have stability anymore, because the raised foundations don't give stability, the floor would crumble and now you could enter or leave the base. This bunker already works in its current form, but I like to add half-height walls onto here with floor triangles on top. I do this to stop people from easily soft-siding these foundations and going into the bunker without needing to raise explosives. Now, because the gap is too large for you to jump out, something that I like to do is placing a floor triangle here, a ladder here, and a ladder hatch here. Now the ladder hatch gives a bit of extra protection to your bunker seal. To close the bunker, we need this ladder. For that, we're going to simply jump into this corner, sneak here, place the half wall, place the floor, and now the bunker works again. Now let's go to the next stability bunker. For this we're going to again place down a square foundation. Walls on these two sides, a half wall here, full wall on top of the half wall, and half wall on top of this full wall. Now the bunker is already pretty much done. This works by us placing a floor triangle on top of this half wall, and a roof on the floor triangle, upgrading a roof. This would be the side which you show to the raiders if they're going for doors. Now, once we destroy this floor frame, the roof will crumble and we will be able to enter or leave the base. This one right here takes up a bit more space vertically, but a lot less in any other direction. And one of the greatest things about it is that because you won't have raised foundations, it will be a lot harder to see from the outside that you have a bunker inside of your base. Now to the next stability bunker. For this we're going to place a square foundation, another one behind it. The first square foundation only gets upgraded to wood, the next one to whatever material you want your bunker to be. On all sides of the wood foundation we're going to place HQM foundations, one raised one in the front, armored walls go on the side. Now we're already done with the bunker. To seal this, we are simply going to stand inside here, take a roof, place it like this, and now if a raider wants to come from here into our bunker, they can't because this roof is blocking the entrance. To open up the seal from the inside, we would have to hatchet out this foundation. This will take a bit more time than the twig ones because we need to upgrade it to wood, but because we can see the soft side, it only should take you either 3 machetes, 1 salvaged sword, or 1 basic metal tool. This foundation needs to be upgraded to wood because if we leave it twig, part of the twig will look to the outside and in fact they can be damaged from destroying the bunker from the outside without needing to destroy an armored building block. Of course, these aren't examples of how you could implement them into your base. That is something that you have to test for your own. Something that I like to do with this style of bunker is a normal 2x2. which would look something like this. Now we have these three squares of space to store all our loot, TC, workbench and things like that. And this square to be our entrance. Now we go to a bit different type of stability bunker. This one uses floor stacking. We are going to use the floor stacking technique I showed in my floor stacking video. Build out like this, as in many of the bases I built in the last time. And now upgrading these three foundations, placing two full walls here and two half walls on top of each other here, and the bunker is complete. So if we place a half wall here and a floor triangle on top, upgrade that. This floor triangle only has 30% stability, which it only gains from this half wall. Because these walls are floor stacked, therefore not giving stability to this floor. Now let's get to a different type of bunker, the roof bunker. This one is pretty hard to put into your actual base design, but is pretty commonly used as your external TC. These can be pretty useful in stopping raiders from griefing your base, or picking out windows or turning around vending machines, because they already have TC. If you put a few of these around your base, the radar would need to destroy all your external TCs, which can easily cost a lot of rockets. This one works by you placing a roof on a square foundation in front like this. Because this wall on this side isn't connected to another wall, it goes in, opening up to allow us to access the TC. And if we want to be even more efficient, we can place a box right here with the TC next to it and access both of them from here. A weakness of this bunker is that a lot of soft sides are exposed, making it easier to soft side in, but this usually isn't a problem because you will have many of them and not a lot of people are willing to soft side 5 or 6 sheet metal walls. Now we're going to bunkers, which we introduced with building 4.0, stair bunkers. The first one I saw of this looked like this. A square with a door frame and a ramp behind. Now we can go through here. But if we place stair spiral triangle like this on here, the stairs will block us from going through the door. But once we place another stair triangle on top, it opens up and we can simply get through the door frame. This one is pretty efficient in the use of your bunker seal, but has a lot of other problems. For example, it is pretty bulky and hard to fit into a base because of its weird appearance. Another thing is that your bunker doesn't actually stop the radar from shooting rockets into your part of the base that is behind it. Like for example, if you had your TC here, any other bunker seal would stop people from shooting your TC from here. But if your TC is exposed like this, the radar can just simply rocket it out from here and then place these stairs himself to gain access into your bunker. Another kind of stair bunker, which I prefer a lot compared to this, uses two squares, a window frame, and normal spiral stairs behind it. These again will block us from going through, but allow us to go through once we place another stair. These ones are even more efficient in their use of your material than this one, but they have the same problem for the radar being able to simply shoot through the window and destroying your loot which is behind it, possibly gaining TC access and being able to build himself. Possibly gaining TC access and building privilege, allowing him to place these stairs himself and get all your loot inside. Another kind of bunker which I don't like at all, but I must say it is the most efficient in terms of protection, is the suicide bunker. As the name tells you, you will have to kill yourself to get in and out of this. To transfer items, we're going to place 4 drop boxes on this wall. Inside of here, we would have our TC, a bag, and boxes or any other kind to store our loot. Because we don't have any type of seal, this bunker by far is the most efficient in protection-wise. But because you have to kill yourself every time you want to transfer loot in and out, I really don't like building with this, which is why you will probably never see me use it in an actual base on my channel. The last type of bunker is the door push bunker. For this we are going to place 2 square foundations next to each other, with triangles in the front, like this. Now we're going to place a roof, like this, which needs to be upgraded to high quality metal. I will show you later why. Walls like this, door frames like this, walls and triangles on top. Now when we fill in our doors, we need to make sure that this door opens to the inside and that this double door opens into that side. And now the bunker already is complete. Now if this were the entrance of our base, we could simply jump in here, close this door. As you can see, we can't get through here, even if this door is destroyed. And if we turn around to here and open this door, it pushes us through here and allows us to enter our base. To get out, we would do the same thing, only using these double doors. These have the same problem as the stair bunkers I showed before, because after destroying all the doors, the radar has view access to almost anything behind, which can be a big problem if this is your seal to your main loot. But I think that this bunker has its uses as the entrance for your base, where after destroying these doors, the radar only can see more honeycomb, which protects your TC. Thank you all for watching this short video. I hope you learned something. Until next time, later.